got a home to go to.
Yeah, but I'm not all that keen on going to it.
Well, you know what you want, don't you?
No, but I'm sure you're going to tell me.
You want to get yourself a wife.
You'd rather spoil my supper.
Turn it off, Claude. You can come out now. I'll send away all my false pride. And I'll forsake all of my life. Yes, I'll be as true can be.
Soon the Phantom Bottle Snatch will be history. Another triumph for Scotland Yard.
Angan's too good for them.
Exactly. So I'll just doss down here unless... Perks are going undercover, eh?
So, have you ever been undercover?
Well, I'm undercover right now, aren't I? Pretending to be a copper from London.
You're probably a bit of a rogue, Mike Bradley.
She sees me there, and she signals me over like a minion, and then says in her lordly way, oh, that's Sergeant Rowan's wife. She teaches here too. Like it's a hobby I've got when I'm not ironing your uniform.
You are my wife.
Yes, but I'm also a professional, so just occasionally it would be nice to be treated like one.
Well, at least you're allowed to do your job. I seem to do nothing but fill in forms, copy forms and... file forms.
Was this to do with the man who died at the station?
Some of it, but not all. No wonder Blayton looked like he was sucking lemons 24 hours a day. It's not coppering.
No, it's promotion.
Yeah, I know. Did you ever get that moment when you look at your life and realise things aren't going to change? That's it. The only thing left to happen is you're going to get old.
No.
Me neither. If you
come, I just haven't met the right bloke yet, that's all.
And when you do, what? Into the wedding frock, zip up the yard, biff baff bosh, what a lovely baby.
No, a bit more casual than that.
A bit more casual?
Yeah. A bit more fun.
Fun.
So what about you then? Haven't you met the right girl yet?
Well, I thought I was getting close.
You're not telling me you've left a weeping woman in London, are you?
A weeping woman and five screaming kids. No. I'm very happy to be on my own. Sort of where I am.
Undercover.
Look, Gina, I don't know what could have happened.
I do. Someone pinched all my bottles again.
Hey, come on. Look, I'm sorry.
You won't catch anything there.
Won't I? Well, I've already caught you because I'm only washing my net.
Do you have permission to do that?
I happen to be a friend of the owner.
Rubbish. I knew Asherley when he was a child. He was a whinging toad then. I doubt he's changed.
You certainly seem to know more about people than you do about fishing.
Really?
Where'd you get them?
Tickled them.
Did you? Well, you don't look all that pleased to me. Tickled them.
Of course I did. Patience and delicacy, that's all it takes. Not that they're qualities I normally admire, mind you.
You almost think I came up the river on a barge.
You're a very contrary man. Come and have breakfast.
What?
Well, do you have a little woman at home, boiling your egg for you and cutting your toast into soldiers?
No and no in that order.
Admit it, you were asleep.
I was not asleep.
Asleep in Gina's lovely arms. In fact, I'd wager a small bet it was you who stole the bottles in the first place just so you could infiltrate her defences.
I admire your technique, really do. In every count, apart from the
crook catching one. And that is a real dog.
Hey, no wonder I didn't hear a car. It's kids. That's who it is.
Kids on bikes.
Yeah, circus kids.
What?
Look at the tracks by a Wather. They're exactly parallel.
Aren't you going to say grace?
What for?
Right answer. No time for religion.
Not the wimpy Christian sort, anyway.
Pan has his moments.
Pan, what are you talking about?
Mythology. If it bores you, we'll move on.
Where do you actually come from?
All over. My great-grandfather explored deserts. I confine myself to England.
Well, are you like a gypsy then or something?
Not at all. Butter, lemon, salt, pepper, help yourself. Not that I don't like gypsies. I got that off one of them. Bartered it for a couple of salmon that happened to fall in my lap by the Tweed. Astrologer she was, complete fraud. Couldn't tell her Aries from her elbow.
Well, you're like a poacher and all then, are you?
Guilty, Your Honour. And I'd like other offences to be taken into consideration.
You've been inside, have you?
Twice.
What for?
Redistributed some wealth. I didn't mind. You meet a more interesting class of person in prison. How's the trout?
Marvellous.
Good. I think I might stay here for a while. Maybe you could show me around. Pheasant should fetch a good price about now, shouldn't it?
Alf, what's the registration of the minivan? Alf?
Ashbury Police. Oh, hello, sir. It's Sergeant Rowan. Where? With PC Bradley. Right, sir. Yeah.
You call, Sarge?
Yeah, where's Bradley?
He's at the Agency Alarms, I think.
Again? It's someone stealing beer bottles, not the great train robbery. But get him on the radio. Tell him to meet me up on the moors at the crossroads of the B151 and the 169. 11:30, sharp.
Yes, please. Look, have you seen this bloke anywhere around here?
Can't say that I have. Well, I do.
Do you know what all this is about?
No, dear Sarge.
Sergeant Rowan, PC Bradley. Bad news, I'm afraid. Martin and Lyndon have been released.
You gotta be joking, sir.
No. Conviction overturned on appeal. They walked free this morning.
On what grounds?
A key witness retracted his identification. Said the police coerced him into it.
Do you mind telling me what all this is about, sir?
Fallout from Bradley's Operation Gunsmoke. It's more than likely that the death in custody put Ashbridley on the map. As you know, Bradley's photo appeared in the Yorkshire Press. The Met persuaded Fleet Street not to identify him, but the damage might already be done.
Do you think these men will come after him?
Bradley was mainly responsible for putting them behind bars, so yes, it's possible.
So his options are whether to move somewhere else or stay here and take his chances?
In a nutshell. What do you want to do, Bradley?
I'd like to think about it, sir.
Well, don't take too long. It'll take time to arrange a new place if you decide to move. The Met have got tails on Martin and Linden, so we'll know if they try to come north. I'm in Scarborough all afternoon. Feel free to phone me.
Thank you, sir.
I'll meet you back at my place. I'll make you lunch.
I was undercover 8 months in one of Martin's clubs in South London. He was running a porn and drugs racket.
One pickle.
Oh, yeah, thanks. And Sammy Linden was his right-hand man. Now, Sam and I, well, we were mates, good mates. Despite what he was doing, that, well, you know, we had the same background, same age, just about the same everything. You know, I used to look at him and think how easily that could have been me.
Do you think he'll come after you?
Well, yeah, it's possible, but on the other hand, why risk prison if you just walk free?
They ever kill anyone?
Well, yeah, I heard rumours, but I never saw any. I mean, a couple of businesses got burnt, a couple of people got beaten up, but that's about it, you know. 15 years each they got. 8 months undercover work, 6 months trial, all for nothing.
So what are you going to do?
I don't know. What do you think I should do, Sarge?
Hello, love. Hello, Mike.
Hello, Mrs. Ryan.
Katie, that's not for you.
Come here, you.
Sorry. Anybody think we didn't feed her?
It's all right, Mrs. Rowan. I'm from a large family. We're kind of used to fighting over food.
That doesn't excuse you, madam, coming from a large family of one. Come on, let's let Daddy and Mike finish their lunch. Nice to see you again.
And you.
So what should you do? Well, the short answer is, it's going to have to be your own decision. The longer answer is, if I found somewhere I liked, I wouldn't let anyone chase me out of it.
I can see that, Sarge. I mean, you're set up for life here, aren't you? What's your game? Not can anybody play?
Tap. Hiya. Can I get you?
A rum and black, please.
Just passing through, are you?
Yeah, passing through the whole of Yorkshire.
Big, isn't it?
Enormous. North Riding, West Riding, Horse Riding. Actually, I'm looking for someone. It's embarrassing. Traipsing around, thrusting that under everyone's nose. Of course, no one knows him. Why should they?
Excuse me, does anyone in here own a green mini?
That's me.
Then would you like to tell me why you've left your baby in it?
I'm sorry.
What's his name?
Tommy. Thomas.
Hello, Tommy. Getting a bit of a tan there, weren't you?
I just popped in for a minute because I'm looking for somewhere to stay the night. I'm fagged out from all this driving.
I can imagine. Where's his dad?
I wish I knew.
Why don't you stay here? I've got a quiet room at the back.
Oh, that'd be nice.
You can use the pub as a base. Why are you looking for this bloke?
Yeah, I'll do that. Thanks.
Afraid it's a bit untidy at the moment. Do a bit of clean up.
Says who? Amount of time people waste cleaning their houses just to get them dirty again. Besides, what chance have you got of getting near a rabbit if you stink of washing up liquid?
Yeah, exactly. Would you like a cup of tea?
Oh, I don't mind if I do. What do they call you, by the way?
Oh, Greengrass, Claude Greengrass.
I had a whippet called Claude. He was run over. I loved him very much. You're hardly a whippet. You got another name?
Oh, me, yeah. Jeremiah, Claude Jeremiah.
Jeremiah. Jeremiah suits you well. A prophet. I only have one name, Tessa. Take it or leave it.
Is it my imagination, or are you from the upper echelon?
Afraid so, Jeremiah. Don't hold it against me.
I don't.
Born with a silver spoon in my mouth, too. Spat that out quick.
Did you?
Oh, yeah. Take it from me. It's a lot more fun poaching off big estates than living on them.
Oh, that's debatable. Would you like to sit down, Tessa? Oh, see if I can find some cups.
I'll be off then, Sarge.
Fine. Have you decided anything yet?
No. Still thinking. Can I ask a question, Sarge? You know, when you left London, how long did it take you before you got used to this place?
Well, I have to say, the first few months, I thought I'd landed on another planet. Took a while, but being with my first wife made it a bit easier, because she knew the place and some of the people.
Well, I'd best get myself a wife, then.
Well, it's easier to make a decision with two people making it, especially when one of them's a woman. Then she'll make it for you. You wait till you're married, you know what I mean.
Excuse me, Sarge. It's for you, Mike. Gina.
So how long do you think you'll be staying, then?
As long as the game lasts. So I hope we'll be seeing rather a lot of each other. Large whiskey and a G&T, please, young lady.
I'm not a waitress, you know.
Sorry about that.
No, Jeremiah, she's right. I'm wrong. This is a pub, not the Savoy.
I'll bring them over.
Hi. I'm glad you called.
Are you?
So, can I get you a drink?
I can get my own drinks. It's my pub.
Yeah, right. You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine, thanks. I don't know about you, though.
What?
I take it you know Penny.
I cut it off.
Suppose you had to. After all, you are a policeman.
Listen, Pen.
Mike, you just left. 6 months together and you just disappeared. Not a word, not nothing. Is that right?
Listen, Pen, is there somewhere else we can talk about this?
I've got a room here.
What? Here?
Yeah. Gina said I could stay.
How did you find me, Pen?
I saw you in the newspaper. Don't worry, they didn't name you, but I knew who it was. I mean, we did get to know each other pretty well, didn't we?
Yeah, we had fun.
And I've got proof of it. Go on, have a look. His name's Thomas. He's yours.
What? But he can't be.
Well, look at him, Mike. Your eyes, your nose. Isn't he a dream?
No, look, it's not possible. How old is he?
6 months.
6 months? Then he was... Well, you must have been pregnant one... Look, you never told me.
Did I get a chance? Well, first of all, I wasn't sure, and by the time I was, you'd gone.
Pen. I'm sorry. Look, I really am. But this baby can't be mine.
Do you think I'd chase you halfway around the country if he wasn't? Can you imagine what it was like when they realised the guy that everyone liked, happy-go-lucky Mike, was a narc? And who was the narc's girlfriend then, eh? Me. Imagine what it was like. Lost my job at the club, had to go back to my parents. But all the time I kept thinking, it's gonna be all right. Mike will come back.
But I didn't know, all right? I didn't know. I mean, oh, this is a nightmare.
No. It's a surprise.
Right, sir. Well, that's something. Yeah, I'll tell him now, sir. Right, sir. The Ice Shiner. Martin and Lyndon boarded a plane to Malta at 6:30 this morning. So you can relax.
All right, thanks, Sergeant.
You all right?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I'm fine.
Right. Well, that's all then.
Right.
No, you did the right thing. He's running a temperature. Where's the mum?
She's looking for somewhere to rent.
She's going to be staying around here?
She's going to be staying.
Well, I need to talk to her to see if she'll let a doctor see him, just to be on the safe side. I'll have a word with Dr. Belton, who's experienced in paediatrics. Did she say anything about where the dad is?
She doesn't know. He ran off. That's why Penny's here. She's looking for him.
Oh, what sort of man could leave a little angel like this, hey?
Won't be a minute, Phil.
You best not be. And give her a kiss from me.
Do you have any form of identification, madam?
I have me. The fact that I am here and that I know the letter is here is proof sufficient.
It's not just the letter, madam. There happens to be money involved. A not inconsiderable sum.
And you want a slice of it? Perhaps I should call the police.
Is there a problem, madam?
Yes. This man is attempting to withhold money that is rightfully mine.
I'm not withholding anything, Bellamy. I'm just trying to establish an identity. This letter here is addressed to the Honourable Miss Tessa Blundell, and this woman here, well, she's a... Well, she's a...
Go on, say it. A tramp. How would I know they were here if I wasn't the addressee?
She has a point, Mr. Blaketon.
You pulling rank, Bellamy?
Sarge. Can I ask you where you're staying, madam?
Just in case you need to interrogate me further. Jeremiah warned me about the police here.
Ah, so you know green grass, do you?
I have that privilege. If you must know, I'm camped on the White Adder, just off the B153.
Well, that's Lord Ashfordley's land, so you're trespassing.
Is Ashfordley complaining? No. Then it's none of your business. Good day.
Don't apologise to me. I couldn't care less. I hardly know you.
Oh, come on, you know it's not true.
Of course it is. The only thing I care about is that you do the right thing for that poor girl.
Penny never told me she was pregnant. I didn't know.
How could she tell you? You just disappeared.
It was my job, right? My job.
What, getting girls pregnant, then disappearing? Oh, lovely job. And you're clearly good at it. Well, it's a good job Penny did show up, or I could have been next.
Hey, come on, you're not being fair.
Fair? Isn't it about time you were fair to your child and the mother of your child?
Gina, I hadn't seen her for over a year. I didn't know. Now it's done, I'll do what I have to do. But don't accuse me of running off when I didn't know anything about it.
Like I said, I couldn't care less.
Lover's tiff?
Yeah, something like that. Guess who I've found? Bot the thief.
Hey, I saw her in the pub last night with Greengrass.
She's camped on the White Adder, off the 153. Looks like she's formed a poaching combo. So we better pay her a visit.
Hey, Phil, you wouldn't mind if I could deal with this one on my own, would you?
Why? So you can get back in Gina's good books?
Yeah, well, something like that.
He's got mild bronchiolitis. It's no wonder he's been complaining.
Is that bad?
It can get very bad, yes. And travelling long distances in a car is no good for a baby this age.
Well, I didn't have much choice, did I?
Where your baby's concerned, you always have a choice.
You got a problem, Mike?
Don't look like I have.
As though someone slammed a car door on your hand. You have something interesting to say to D.I. Shiner yesterday, did you? Something about the death in custody, was it?
Yeah, something like that.
Well, if you've got a problem, you want to talk to someone. Not me, I'm too old. You want to try Sergeant Rowan. Of course, he won't be able to help, but at least it'll give us something to gossip about afterwards.
Yeah, well, thanks very much, Alf.
You a secret drinker?
They're empties.
They are now.
No, no, I liberated them from Gina. Before I met her, before I was invited under her roof, so to speak. I'm feeling a bit guilty. There's a few bob there.
Yeah? Well, how'd you like me to take them to her, tell her I've found them somewhere, and I'll sell them back to her for half what she can get to them? That way she gets a bit, we get a bit, and you don't feel guilty.
Jeremiah, you should be at the United Nations.
Sounds like me. Hey, how'd you like a bit of supper?
What, now?
No, later.
Yes, I expect I will.
No, I mean, with me, like, you know, at my place. Dinner supper.
I'd like that very much, Jeremiah. On one condition.
What's that?
I cook. Lord Ashfordley supplies the food.
Well, he's not coming at all, is he?
Not in your Nelly.
She worked in Martin's Club. Barmaid. Well, sometimes a stripper, but she hated that, you know. We got on, you know. Really got on. Well, you know what it's like being undercover, Sergeant. Sometimes you forget who you are, you know, and... Well, Pen, she kept me sane, you know, on the level. But that was then, and... I thought it was all over. Done and dusted. It's a mess, Sarge.
Look, I know what you're going to say. I've made my bed and I should lie in it. You're right.
I don't know what to say. Sounds like a bit of a minefield for you and for her.
Look, Sarge, I didn't know anything about the kid. I mean, I wish I had, because... Well, maybe I could have done... Maybe I would have done something different. I don't know.
Are you sure it's yours, Mike?
I'll ask the same question. She swears to it, and I believe her. Well, I was Sammy Linden's best mate, you know. No one would dare mess with my girl.
Well, I don't know what to do, to be honest. Did your bosses at the Met know about the affair?
Know about it? Yeah, they encouraged it, you know, said it made me safer. Not that I needed much encouragement, though. I was really stuck on it.
How's the baby, Maggie?
Oh, he'll be okay. They're going to keep him in overnight at the hospital, just to be sure. Oh, I promised Penny I'd pick up some overnight things for her, so I might as well come back with you. I do hope she means what she says about settling down. Shouldn't be running around the country with a 3-month-old kid.
What, the baby's only 3 months old?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes. I have seen one or two babies, Gina.
Where's the baby's father?
Goodness knows. That's why she's running around the country.
Oh, it's disgusting. Men like that should be locked up.
Brilliant. And that'd do the family a whole lot of good, wouldn't it?
Right. Here's to us and those that like us.
What about the rest?
Yeah.
Sorry to call so late. I wanted to have a word.
Nothing wrong, is there?
Well, not exactly wrong, no.
Well, if you think I can help, come through.
What's your favourite month, Jeremiah?
Favourite month? I don't know. November, I think.
Why so?
Well, I love it when it's really cold outside. You know, you can get a big roaring log fire going. Not only that, it's the time of the year when people start putting their orders in for their Christmas dinners. Yeah, of course, I suppose when you come to think about it, I'm in my November, aren't I? I mean, December's only just round the corner.
Oh, nonsense, Jeremiah. You're in your high summer, with Christmas once a fortnight.
Thank you very much. Don't it get a bit parky in that camper of yours in the winter?
Well, I make sure I've got enough blankets.
Yeah. Well, if you ever feel like bringing your blankets round here, you'll be very welcome, you know.
Do I have to wait till it's cold?
No.
I'm very untidy.
Join the club.
Liberated from the post office.
Are they dark chocolate?
Of course.
Dark chocolate digestives liberated from Oscar Blaketon.
But what I think, if you've got a problem that seems insoluble, you've got to be bold. Cut the knot. He'll have to go and she'll have to go with him.
What, leave here?
Leave Yorkshire. This Penny, she'll know these crooks. She'll have to protect her kid. Looks like you're going to lose a good copper.
It's not me I'm worried about.
Well, he's sowed his wild oats, and they've grown up, and they've trapped him.
Pretty much.
Well, I always said it. There's no such thing as free love. What's it like, then, being Sergeant Rowan?
Well, I've got to be honest. I think I prefer being a PC.
Roll back the years, shall we? I wish.
Mike?
Yeah?
When did you last see Penny?
Well, why do you want to know?
Just tell me.
Look, I did tell you. It was over a year ago.
More than 12 months, and you say you didn't know she was pregnant.
Look, I didn't know, and if I had, I would have told you.
I'm not interested. How old did she tell you the baby was?
6 months. Gina, will you tell me what's going on?
Well, the district nurse, Maggie Bolton, says the baby's only 3 months old.
Are you any good at maths?
Dr. Bolton. PC Bradley, Ashley.
Of course. Is something wrong?
No, not really. You've got a patient here. Someone I need to talk to.
Oh, no, no, I'm sorry. It's much too late.
Her name's Penny Gilbert. She's got a baby with her. His name's Tommy.
Do you know Miss Gilbert?
Yeah. Yeah, I do.
Come with me.
Doctor. The baby. How old is he?
Your child has bronchiolitis. That is not a good idea.
I'm sorry.
5 minutes.
Pen, when was Thomas born?
I told you, 6 months ago.
Doctor says he's 3 months old.
Well, he's wrong. I mean, I should know, shouldn't I? I was there.
The doctor says your baby is 3 months old. He's not my child, Pen.
All right, he's not yours. But he could have been. The way you treated me is what you deserved.
Now look, I know I deserved a lot, but not this. And this kid certainly doesn't deserve me.
Oh, you're so pompous. The second I found out you were a cop, I knew what you'd be like.
So why'd you come here if you knew it wasn't mine?
Because I had nowhere else to go. Because I thought you loved me.
Hey,
oh, big deal, I woke him up. I'll tell you who else ought to wake up, and that's you. I found out where you are. But I'm not the only one looking for you.
What are you saying?
I'll tell him where you are. Pay me £500 or I'll tell Sammy Linden where you are.
I don't have £500.
£400 and I'll disappear and you won't have to see me again.
You hate me that much, dear?
I need the money.
Penny, who's the baby's father?
£400 or I'll tell him where you are.
Look, I'm not afraid of Sammy Linden or Clive Martin. I wasn't afraid when I went undercover, and I'm not afraid of them now.
Just give me the money.
Would you have gone through this if I hadn't found out? Would you have gone on pretending he was mine?
I don't know.
Fill you up, mate.
Ah. How much you give me for it? I want to sell it. Cash.
I'll have to ask boss.
They're raiding Lord Ashfield's woods, that's what they're doing.
It's not our old friend Claude Jeremiah Greengrass, is it?
No way. I've lost more pheasants in the last 2 days than I have in the whole year. So I know it's professionals, not that useless sack of chaff. What I don't know is what you're doing about it.
Actually, an arrest is imminent.
What?
We've had the suspects under surveillance for some time now, and, well, we'll be making our move very shortly.
Oh, well. In that case... it's good to see some new blood here at last.
The Maltese police say that Martin and Linden were not on the plane when it arrived in Malta. So they could be anywhere. Could be up to anything. Bradley should definitely consider himself at risk. You should put your lads on general alert. Report anything suspicious to me.
There is something, sir. A woman called Penny Gilbert. She used to work for Martin and Linden. She knew Bradley. She's tracked him down and claims that he's the father of her child.
Do you believe her?
He does. He'll have to be moved from Ashfordley, sir. So will she.
Yes. Keep her out of sight. At least until the Met get tabs on these villains again. I'll be in touch.
Hi.
Hiya.
Is Penny back?
Not yet. I'm expecting her about 10 o'clock.
Can you give her a message for me?
Don't you want to do it yourself?
Look, just tell her I've got what she wants and she should meet me at 11 o'clock on the Ashfordley estate, just off the B153. Do you know where that is?
I can look on a map.
And tell her to have her bags packed.
Mike, what's going on?
Thanks for the phone call last night. It meant a lot to me.
Just tell me. Is the baby yours?
Penny admitted it wasn't.
So what are you going to do?
What? Give her some money? Let her get a fresh start? It's what she wants.
Have you got money?
I had a bike, though. Look, Gina, don't tell anyone about this. Not for me, not for my sake, but for hers. She's all messed up. She needs help.
Is that the right sort of help?
That's all I can do.
See you about half an hour.
I'll grab us a salmon for lunch.
Make it the biggest. I feel it in my
toes. What's your favourite month now?
I don't know. July? Perhaps even June.
Getting younger every day, Jeremiah.
I better go before you have to change my nappy.
Where's PC Bradley?
He's visiting the Honourable Tessa Blundell, Sarge.
Who?
Greengrass's new partner.
Poacher and a bottle snatcher.
Right, we'll get him on the radio, and when he's done, I need him back here, and he's to stay close to the station. Tell him why.
So is this where you live, then?
No. I'm on a job.
Mike, I knew you might have lived somewhere like this. So have you got it, then?
£360. That's all I got. That's all I could get. You clean me out.
So, you learn more.
Let's get this straight. That's all you're getting. If you come back here asking for more, I'll arrest you for blackmail.
Oh, tough cop, ain't you?
If I have to be. Listen, I ain't moving from here, Ben. If they want to find me, they know where I am. If you see Sammy Linden, you tell them that.
Oh, I'd love to. See you, Mike. What a waste.
Yeah. Just what I was thinking.
Ron? Penny Gilbert. She didn't used to work for Martin. She still does. What's more, she used to visit Linden every week in prison.
So she sent Bradley up.
Where is he?
Hello, Mikey. Been a long time.
How much did he pay you, Pen?
£1,000.
You're easily bored, aren't you? And my money, what's that? Just a bonus?
Serves you right.
Yeah, I suppose it does. But then I won't have to live with what I've done for the rest of my life, will I?
Get out of here, Pen. You did good.
It's his, isn't it? The baby. My God. What sort of man would use his own son?
Do like I said, Pen, and get!
Gina says that Bradley arranged to meet Penny at 11 o'clock at Tessa Blundell's campsite. Over.
You know where that is?
Yeah, it's off the 153 Lord Ashfordley's land. Roger, Alf. Anything else? Over.
Two men answering the suspect's description stopped for petrol on the A1 in Lincolnshire last night. They were heading north. D.I. Shiner has asked for armed backup. Over.
Alf, with respect, tell D.I. Shiner armed backup
won't get there in time. Tell him roadblocks. Over.
Suggestion taken on board,
Sergeant Rowan.
Roadblocks will be arranged. Out.
It's right here. It's right here.
Six months I've waited for this, Mikey.
You're making a big mistake, Sammy.
Nothing to what you made, mate.
Oh, come on. You were off scot-free. No cops after you, nothing. Coming off to me is a big mistake. Think about it. You could be in Spain now, getting a tan. Penny and little Thomas by your side.
Oh, shut up!
Come on, you know I'm right.
You think I could hold my head up if I let you get away with what you did? Do you think anyone would do business with me? Do you? What we're gonna do, Mike, is teach you a lesson. So you don't forget what you did. So no one else forgets.
This is a beautiful weapon. A masterpiece.
Miss Tessa Blundell?
The Honourable Tessa Blundell, to be precise.
Yeah, if you're thinking of going to your campsite, you shouldn't. We've a spot of trouble up there.
Trouble doesn't concern me. Protecting my property does. I shall approach in a circumspect manner.
Do you know another way in?
Do fish swim?
Killing me makes a lot of sense, doesn't it? You won't even get out of the county.
Who said anything about killing? I've never killed anyone in my life. Never had to. Injury can be just as effective.
Sit down!
Halt! That's my property!
Thank you, Miss Blundell.
Honourable.
You all right?
Yeah, fine, Sarge.
You did a good job?
No, I let myself get caught.
But it's over.
Wish it was. He'll be back. Now, I've been thinking about it, Sarge. I'm gonna have to leave.
Assault on a constable in the execution of his duty. Actual bodily harm, malicious damage, larceny, that's just for starters. They're looking at 8 to 10 years minimum. At the end of that, you think they want to come back? I doubt it. If you want to stay here, it's yours.
Well, that business with the bottles took longer than I thought. Gina thought I'd nicked them. Anyhow, they only came to 7 and a tanner, so seeing as I'm a generous and wonderful person, you can have it.
No, you keep it.
Go on, you talk me into it. Why have you brought the van? Have you decided to move in?
No, I'm moving on.
I thought...
Violence at my campsite, Jeremiah. Violence at my hearth. I don't like it. I'm moving on.
Will you be back?
Depends where the road leads, doesn't it? Don't forget, Jeremiah. Christmas every fortnight.
Mike Bradley decided what he'll do.
Well, I think he'll stay. Find him a good woman and he'll stay.
Is that all you need? A good woman?
What do you mean?
You're thinking of leaving Aidensfield, aren't you?
I'm thinking of leaving England.
What?
Well, what do you think? You, me and Katie. Try somewhere new, completely new. Would you like that?
I don't know.
You wanted me to come over? Well, it was you who called, wasn't it?
Yeah. Someone's been pinching my empties again.
Look, Gina, we've been through all this already.
So now's your chance to get it right?
Gina, what have you done?
I bought it for you. You'll have to pay me back, mind. With interest.
Well, yeah, of course. I mean, it's fantastic, but why?
I don't know. Maybe because it's the only reason I fancied you.
So you fancy me, do you?